people, and welcome to another edition of yours truly, Josiah Willis. Here there with another reaction. Let's go right ahead and get back to it. Back to some R&B music. I think. I heard a little snippet of it. I ain't gonna lie to you guys. I'm just gonna keep it real and honest with you guys. I heard a snippet of this record. This album has been out, and people are listening to it. It's one of the biggest artists to ever do music, and you should know who I'm referring to. Well, I'm going to tell you anyways. Beyoncé. I'm That Girl. No, I'm not a girl, though. But I'm That Girl. I believe is I'm going to react to the official lyric video. It is produced by Beyoncé herself and Kelman Duran. All right. So, as we know, July 29th, 2002 will forever be the full release date of Renaissance. I think it's called Act 1, because I think it's Act 2 or Act 3. Maybe Act 2 is going to come out afterwards, but I don't know. All I know is this is Beyoncé's, what, 7th, 8th album? Give me a second, you guys. I think it's very important for me to know that. Hold on right quick. Hold on. And no, I'm not counting the Jay-Z project, I think, solo-wise. Okay, yes, 7th album by Beyoncé. Great. Thank you, Internet. But yes, we are here, and we're going to check it out. Yes, there will be a lyrical breakdown provided once the song is over. Stay tuned. I said that very early. And this will be the last reaction for today. But until then, ladies and gentlemen, please do me a quick favor. And that is to like, comment, subscribe, and views. Put your minds out there. The link of this song will be down in my description below. This is Beyoncé's I'm That Girl. The official lyric video. Track number one, by the way. All right. You guys ready? I'm ready. Let's go.
I've been thugging for my American life, flexing these deep, flawless skies.
picking up the steam right now.
Bring that beat in. I can breathe again. Yeah. I'll be beating down the block, knocking Basquiat's off the wall.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
That's how I ball.
Okay.
Cleanse me of my sins. My un-American life.
What an intro. Wow, and that's it? Hecking, what'd you have there? Okay, so let's go right ahead and get towards the lyrical breakdown minus the intro before we get into details regarding the song's message. verse one. I pull up in these clothes, look so good, because I'm in the L. What am I talking about? Am I trying to be degrading or anything? You know, all these songs sound good. Because I'm on that hoe. She's serious. Serious. I'm serious. Okay. So that was the first verse. Here's the chorus. She said, it's not the diamonds. It's not the pearls. I'm that girl. She'll need jewelry to show off the truest form of Beyonce. I believe so. Right? It doesn't define who she is or her character. Right? You believe that? Or not. It's just that I'm that girl. It's not my man. It's not my stance. I'm that girl. It's just that I'm that girl. It's not even about Jay-Z. It's not even about what she's worth in terms of, like, you know, all this other stuff. And when it comes to, I mean, it's about what she's worth, but at the same time, she's not, I guess the way she's looking at it from her standpoint of looking at someone's stance is that, it's not my stance. That just got me thinking right now. I am truly thinking about that right now. I'm not even lying to you guys. I should really give y'all an easier answer. But the way I'm going to interpret is not the way she may be standing on top of her place in the music industry or even in the game. You know, or how long she's been doing it as far as her longevity. It's just the fact that she's been, you know, great, synonymous with being popular, famous. She already knew from the beginning she was going to have success one way or another. So that's how I'll take it. Here we go. Verse 2. From the top of the morning, I shine right through the blinds, touching everything in my plain view, and everything next to me gets lit up too. You see it? Yeah. You see it when you look to me. I didn't want this power. And then you're somebody in the background. I didn't want it. I didn't want this power. She didn't want to go ahead and reign. You know, she's a queen bee. You feel what I'm saying? She got her kingdom. Whether that be imaginary or just the fact that she is. She do have her queendom, you know what I'm saying? And maybe that's her house. Her mansion, perhaps. Bridge, you know love is my weakness. Don't need drugs for some freak. I'm just high all the time. I'm out of my mind. I'm tweaking. So she just herself. She don't need no substance in her system to get high or to feel that she's very vulnerable about her love. You know, of course, Jay-Z, but just having love in general. She's just part of a truly down-to-earth person when it comes down to it. And she part goes far beyond love. That's what she's saying here. Verse 3. Think. Freaking on the weekend. I'm indecent. Let it begin. I be pulling up that 92 DeVille Cadillac with them Vogues. All right, so she balling out. She got the, you know, the old school 1992 DeVille Cadillac. You know what I'm saying? And she's arriving in Vogues. Meaning she's arriving in style. She's definitely arriving when it comes down to it. I think also it was a shout out to The Dream. Because I think he also co-wrote the song. Had I did my research, I would have known that. But yeah, losing my mind. And then she says, beastin', un-American. I don't need no friends. I've been thugging for my un-American life lights. She's not American. She wants to, you know, consider herself to be black. but not American. Okay. In these D-fall-less skies. I see what she did there. D-fall-less skies. Flawless was a song by Beyonce. Nice reference. But in her skies, she's on cloud nine. She's really up there. You know what I'm saying? Her life lights are shining, as she said a verse ago. Off the deep end, such a heathen. Why they let me outside? I'll pull relief in. Bring the beat in. Now I can breathe again. I'll be beating down the block and knocking Basquiat's off the wall. So, it's a reference to American artist Jean-Michel Basquiat. Beyonce and Jay-Z are, when they're together, they are relatively known for their love for fine art. They have showpieces from Pablo Picasso before, Andy Warhol, and Basquiat, with many more to name a few. And so, I think around 2012, if I'm not mistaken, I saw this post. Well, I remember this post had came up somehow on my cell phone. Well, did I have a cell phone around that time? Maybe I didn't. I don't remember. But anyways, I do remember they had purchased a painting of Basquiat's. It was called Mecca. And do you know how much it cost? I'll wait. Generally speaking, $4.5 million cash, I guess. I don't know, credit, crash. However they did it, they bought that. And then I believe Jay-Z has mentioned Basquiat before in songs like Ill as Mother, you know, Alive, and then Picasso Baby. So once again, nice tie into the reference, continuity of Beyonce's career. And then she says, that's how I ball. Cleanse me of my sins, my un-American life. This is interesting, because once again, I really want to get to Renaissance. Renaissance, as we all know, is, you know, the Renaissance back then, from years ago. But I think the Renaissance is Beyonce coming into her new outlook on life. So I don't know. Maybe that could be a potential theme throughout the project. We'll have to give it a check out. If y'all want me to do some more records requests, I will not do all the songs on here. No offense, but I want to get to other artists, even though I know people are going to look at me like it's a hypocrite. You did the full songs from Billie Eilish. You did the full songs from LMI. Well, when I had time and there was no request, I did something. But then again, still no excuse. Maybe I'll get to Beyonce and do some more records off this project. If not, like I said, we move on with some more artists. Just request them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this reaction, please do me a quick favor, and that is to like, comment, subscribe, and views, put your minds out there. The link of this song will be down in my description below. This was Beyonce's I'm That Girl, not me. Produced by Beyonce and herself and Kelman Duran from the official lyric video from the album Renaissance Act 1. Love you guys once again. King Life, we are out.